Good morning. Our Requiem Mass today is offered for the repose of the soul of Liam Donaghy. Our condolences to his wife Maria, his son Shea, and his family and friends who have turned out in such great numbers this morning. At the beginning of our Mass, the symbols from Liam's life will be brought to the altar, offering us a little vignette into the three-dimensionality of the man, and I invite forward Joey, Molly, and Marcus, who will bring to the altar a Manchester United top, a Tyrone jersey, and a newspaper. Life, Liam cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life, come blessed of my Father. In baptism, Liam received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. My sisters and brothers, we believe that all the ties of friendship and affection that knit us together during our lives do not unravel with death. Conscious that God remembers the good that we have done and forgives us our human failings, we call to mind this morning his servant Liam, that he may gaze eternal upon the face of his Creator, his Redeemer, and his Sanctifier. Let us pray. Lord, in our grief we turn to you. Are you not the God of love who open your ears to all? Listen to our prayers for your servant Liam, whom you have called out of this world. Lead him to your kingdom of light and peace, and count him among the saints in glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord. You may be seated for our readings. And I invite forward Molly, who will lead us in the first reading, and Danny, who will lead us in the second reading.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain he will remove the mourning veil covering all people and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said. said, "See, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain, after such a gift, that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, can anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus? No. He not only died for us, he rose from the dead, and there at God's right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing, therefore, can come between us and the love of Christ. Even if we are troubled or worried or being persecuted or lacking food or clothes or being threatened or even attacked, these are the trials through which we triumph by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death nor life, no angel, no prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or height or depth, nor any created thing can ever come between us and the love of God made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On the first day of the week, two of the disciples were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem. And they were talking together about all that had happened. Now, as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side, but something prevented them from recognizing him. When they drew near the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. "It is nearly evening," they said, "and the day is nearly over." So he went in to stay with them. Now while he was with them at table, he took bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?" They set out at that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, "Yes, it is true, the Lord has risen and had appeared to Simon." Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him at the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord. Our Requiem Mass today is offered for the repose of the soul of Liam Donaghy. Yesterday, while planning for today's Requiem Mass, the Donaghy family shared with me many wonderful memories they had of a husband, a father, a brother in a house of sisters, and a friend. It is impossible to describe a loved one in isolation. That is why at our funerals there is the great tradition of recounting the stories and memories of so many at the wake, in order to piece together a likeness of our beloved dead with all the color and vibrancy of a mosaic on the chapel's east wall. All who visited their home in Kilmore Park over the last 48 hours contributed to the creation of a true portrait of a special person named Liam Donaghy. Liam was born in the Royal in Belfast on the 16th of October 1967, the only boy to Willie and Winnie Donaghy. He grew up with his sisters on the Armagh Road in Portadown. A student of the Academy in Dungannon, it was on the school bus where he met Maria, who was at the convent in Dunmore. The Academy instilled in young Liam great devotion to Tyrone, as it happens, as an Armagh man, which he would in time, like any faithful convert, pass on to his own son, Shea. As a young man, he travelled to America, where for 5 years he worked with a roofing company in Florida. When his father took ill in 1995, he returned home to work for the family business and aptly filled his father's shoes as newsagent and general merchant of banter and crack. It was also during this time that he rekindled his teenage romance with Maria. And it came to pass that the butcher's daughter married the newsagent's son. In God's dear providence, of course, there are no accidents. Perhaps the groundwork for this perfect union had been put in years previously, as both Maria and Liam's mothers would go to Loch Derg together for their time of retreat and prayer. Both of these ladies cherished their faith and passed this on to their children, and were delighted in the union. In 2004, Liam and Maria became parents when their home rang to the pitter-patter of tiny feet in their son, Shay. Liam was very natural with children. He could recognize in him an instant affection and rapport. As such, he was a popular coach for the youth at Ballyhagan Davits, and the apple not falling far from the tree, Shea trains there in his Tyrone jersey, no doubt trying to convert more young Armagh ones to the Tyrone cause. Liam was a big man with a bigger heart, who had time for people, who would always do you a good turn, and always had the necessary contact as the fixer, whether you needed football or rugby tickets, a plumber or a flat roof repaired instantly, he knew to whom you should go. He will be sorely missed by his family, friends, and by our community. These are only a few salient memories, vignettes from a life and an individual history, Liam's story that cannot be confined to the printed page or told completely by one voice. Today, as Liam's family and friends gather here to celebrate his life and bid him farewell in this Requiem Mass, in some ways we can understand how those two disciples felt as they trudged wearily back home that Easter Sunday. Like us, they were plunged into gloom because someone whom they had loved had died. Jesus, their mentor and friend, who had filled their lives with such direction and purpose and excitement and eternal meaning, was dead. For them, his history seemed to have ended, not in glory, but in death upon a cross. And then something changes. Our blessed Lord joins them, as he joins us here now. He walks with them and listens, encouraging them to talk as they pour out their sad story to him. Like a wake, they relax into their new company, and each disciple shares how Jesus had left his mark upon them uniquely. Our Lord tenderly, patiently responds to their broken hearts and speaks. He too gives 100% of his attention to those who need a listening ear. And in effect, he takes up the story where they had left off and shows them that his death was not the end. The very person for whom they grieve walks with them anew. Just like Jesus, Liam would journey through his own Good Friday with the cross of ill health, which would be his recovery and death. And like Jesus, this is not the end of Liam's story, because no one who carries the cross ever does so alone. And where there is a cross, the glory of the resurrection beckons just beyond the horizon. It is said that we all have many days to live, but only one day to die. And Liam demonstrates, with all the abiding presence of a dad, that the life we live is infinitely more important than the way that we die. Because death for the Christian is not the end of our history, and this is not the end of Liam's history either. Today we give thanks to God for his life story. We give thanks to the same God who continues to listen, to walk with each one of us upon our own journey to Emmaus, and who reminds us that Liam's story continues in an eternity of peace, of rest, where there will be no more pain, no more sorrow, no more suffering, but only love. And love whispers beyond the grave, I have risen. And may Christ arise in you, in each one of you, in the love you have for Liam, which lasts forever, as the story of your lives continues to unfold and be recorded in the interactions that you have with your friends and your family today. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite forward Sarah, Lisa, Ben, and Jilly, who will lead us in the prayers of the faithful. Please stand.
Liam in his illness, that all of them will be rewarded with their gentleness and care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For deceased relatives and friends, and especially deceased members of the Donaghy and Knox families, may they enjoy deep peace in their heavenly home forever. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And for those who are ill at this time, remembering especially those who will die this day, we pray that our God of strength and compassion will be with them in their hour of need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And for the anniversaries that occur. Margaret Gilbert Nee McConville, Mary O'Neill, Mary Byrne, Herbert, Betty, and Mary Campbell, and Peggy Marley. May they rest in peace.
Amen.
May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. You may be seated. And I invite forward Amy and Kira, who will bring the bread and wine to the altar. Acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
Amen.
his funeral day, we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation. That should have any state of sin afflict him, or any human faults have affected him, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels and thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we adore. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. My Lord and my God. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullest of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Liam, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," put not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be named
Communion, we ask to come up the center way and join me the sides. The will of the minister go to the back and to the side. Thank you.
Thank you.
our mortal bodies to conform with his glorified body. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Liam, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Liam, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help those of us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in you and with our brother forever. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.